100% handmade shoe. Hand-lasted, hand-welded, hand-stitched outsole. Just really delivers on the details that you would expect. This is the final video in the Chinese Handmade Shoemaker review and comparison series. The Chinese Handmade Shoemaker has risen in visibility, popularity, and most importantly, the quality that they're able to craft and deliver. I'm going to focus on the overall aesthetic of the shoes, how well I think they're executed, the quality of the actual craftsmanship and materials, and finally, what my thoughts are from a recommendation standpoint. I'm going to look at these shoes and do a side-by-side comparison, but I'm going to compare them to other shoemakers so that you can kind of get an idea for shoes that you've already had some hands-on experience with and what you can expect when it comes to these in comparison to those. I do want to start with a disclosure, and this is the same disclosure I've mentioned in all of the previous videos in this series. I did not pay for these shoes. I had reached out to each of these shoemakers. I pitched them my idea and the reason that I wanted to do this type of series, asked them if they would like to participate, and part of that participation is providing a pair of shoes that I would be able to unbox, where really kind of put through their paces so that I can go ahead and share my overall thoughts on the individual shoe and more broadly a comparison of the, you know, best representation of the handmade shoes that are being made in China today. Let's take a look at the shoemakers we're featuring in this video. I'll link all the previous videos as well as the full playlist right here. Wait until after this video to watch the earlier ones if you haven't already seen them, but this is Yearn Shoemaker. This is a pair from Blazing Wonders, also known as Helen Shoemaker or BW Shoe Factory on Instagram. And last but certainly not least, this is Acme Shoemaker. Specifically, this is a pair from their Marvel collection. Let's start with Yearn Shoemaker. I got two pairs from Yearn Shoemaker, and I did this in coordination with William from Arterton, London. They are the distributor for Yearn Shoemaker, both in the UK as well as throughout Europe. He felt that this would kind of give the best representation of the quality work and the types of shoes that Yearn Shoemaker is able to produce and deliver. All of their shoes are hand-lasted, hand-welded, and the ready-to-wear shoes like this have machine-stitched outsoles. What we have here is a suede double monk strap that retails for roughly $480. This is CFstead suede. This is on their soft square last. And overall, I think the quality of the leather coming from CFstead, it's a very reputable and some would argue one of the most high quality suede producers throughout the world. This is the Balmoral boot from Yearn Shoemaker. It's on a classic round last, and it's got a dark suede shaft with a mid-brown upper. This boot retails for $500. When looking at this Balmoral boot in comparison to the double monk strap, I definitely prefer the aesthetic, and I think the overall execution of the double monk strap from a standpoint of creating a harmonious shoe that has a well-balanced pattern, a well-balanced last, the double monk strap is better. Boots are pretty difficult though. Nailing the last and pattern execution, especially in the area that we're looking at right here, where the anatomical shape and the last kind of transitions from the ankle down to the instep, to the vamp, to the toe cap. I think this gradient or this slope is not entirely true to the anatomical shape of a foot. And that does have some, you know, direct impacts on the comfort and the overall, you know, accuracy of the fit. Taking a look at Blazing Wonders now, this is a sweeping double monk strap with a plain toe on a soft square chiseled last. This is in black box calf from the Weinheimer tannery. This has 100% handmade construction, hand-lasted, hand-welded, hand-stitched outsoles, and hand finishing throughout the entire shoe, which really delivers on the hallmarks of a bespoke handmade shoe. So this pair of shoes retails for $700. For that price point, I think this is just an overall fantastic buy. Now, it's not without its opportunities and not without its, you know, potential criticisms. I'll get into that. But starting with just the overall, you know, impression of the shoe, just really delivers on the details that you would expect to see in a handmade shoe. Next, we have here Acme Shoemaker. This is from their Marvel collection. This shoe retails for $950. This is just a really well executed, a very nicely balanced pattern and last. This is a hand-lasted, hand-welded, hand-stitched outsole, 100% handmade shoe. This shoe has very nice finishing. All of the major items on here are executed very cleanly. The only kind of opportunities that I would call out here are the shoe trees and the punch holes on the buckles. I go into more detail. I even made a video about how I added additional punch holes here, but basically on the shoe tree, this came with an original ring that you kind of use to hook and pull out the shoe tree. That just made a lot of noise, and I just wasn't a fan of that.
Like this.
This is much more silent. There's no metal clanging noise. So what I did is I just replaced what they originally had here with this classic like metal knob. As far as the buckle, there's only one punch hole on the monk strap. Because I have a bit of a high instep, that just wasn't very accommodating for me. So I was able to add two extra punch holes and problem solved. That said, I get for a $950 shoe, not everybody is going to want to have to add their own punch hole. And I shared that feedback with Acme, and I would be surprised if that's not something that they're looking to accommodate and make more accessible for everyone. Now let's get into some of the up-close detailed views and comparisons here. Let's start with Yearn Shoemaker. It's hand-lasted, hand-welded, machine-stitched outsoles, premium leather from reputable tanneries, and overall a very resilient leather outsole. The overall finishing on the welt, just looking at the fudging, the stitch density, all of those types of things. If you wanted to compare this to a more common shoe, think like TLB Majorca, Carmina, and some of the other, you know, $400 to $500 factory made shoes. And you can see that here. It's almost more refined on the TLB shoe. Now, that's not a criticism of Yearn Shoemaker. The reason that I mentioned, though, is to ensure that you are as informed as possible about, you know, what trade-offs you're making in order to be able to get a handmade shoe for under $500. Now let's look at Blazing Wonders. When we look up close here at the welt finishing, the overall aesthetic, just what do we expect when it comes to comparing these to some of the other shoes? The stitch density, as well as the accuracy of the fudging, absolutely impeccable. This is some of the highest stitch density that I've seen amongst any of my handmade shoes. If we just take a quick side-by-side and we compare this to some of the other like full handmade shoes that I have here, as we look at Antonio Meccariello's arm range against Blazing Wonders, you can see, you know, I wouldn't say that it's identical and that it's as elegant and refined and as detailed, but just the density of the stitching is quite near, you know, identical, if not a little higher on the Blazing Wonders. Also, now, if we compare this with Acme's mainline, this is a full like MTO custom pattern here. When we look at this side by side, very similar in comparison with the Meccariello. The overall execution and refined details with this like edge wall on the fudge wheel, you know, that exists here on the Acme and the Meccariello, where it didn't here in Blazing Wonders. But again, just the stitch density, like how many stitches per inch, you know, Blazing Wonders is definitely in the same ballpark, if not, you know, in a little bit of a better ballpark. When we talk about the overall silhouette, you know, let's start from the heel. And as we go around, you can see a very distinct arch support built in here, extended leather heel stiffeners all the way throughout the arch. All of the hallmarks that you would expect to see from a bespoke shoe are here. They're present. There's definitely the opportunity for them to be a little more accurate and executed a little bit better than what you're seeing right here. Just for another point of reference, if we go back and compare this with Acme's mainline collection, when you look at this transition from the welt into the blind welted waist into the notched shoemaker's notch here at the heel, this is very, very clean. When we look over here at the Blazing Wonders, you can see there's a little inconsistency in just the overall bevel and finishing. There's a little bit of a wave right here. Now, let's be honest, I'm nitpicking to the highest degree. You know, most of the folks that are interested in shoes like this are going to nitpick. Having the information is always a good thing, and then you can make the most informed decision. Now, as we get into the Marvel collection from Acme Shoemaker, the Marvel line is intended to be a more accessible shoe, more broadly appealing to the general, you know, shoe enthusiast. So it's under $1,000, has all of the premium you know, details executed very cleanly and accurately, but you're not going to get all of the same bespoke details that you get from their main line. The overall silhouette, the balance, the last grading, the pattern grading, all of that is just, it's quite impeccable. I don't have much that I could nitpick on here. When we just look at how well balanced this is, the overall aesthetic and silhouette that you see right here, I just absolutely love it. They've really done a great job of, proportionally speaking, like making this shoe, the pattern and the last really are meant for one another. A few callouts that, you know, I would kind of be neglecting them if I didn't make a point of is, you know, they are the most expensive of the three. At $950, it is not a cheap shoe. Now, when we compare these side by side and we're looking at Blazing Wonders and Acme, you can clearly see the stitch density on the hand-stitched outsole from Blazing Wonders is a higher stitches per inch than that on the pair from Acme. Let's get into the recommendations, and I want to share who I think these shoes are best made for. Those looking for a full handmade shoe but are in the budget range of a TLB, Carmina, or Crockett & Jones, yet you still want something a little more, something akin to a bespoke looking shoe while staying within your budget, this is exactly what Yearn Shoemaker excels at, and I would definitely recommend them if that's exactly what you're looking for. Blazing Wonders offers a strong price to value proposition. For those of you looking for all of the signs of a bespoke shoe, the blind waist, high stitches per inch on the outsole, Blazing Wonders is able to do this, and they're going to be able to do it at a much more accessible and affordable price point than if you were to get the full bespoke experience from someone else. The Acme Marvel Collection is just a fantastic shoe, as well it should be for a retail price of $950. These are really for those who want the best possible shoe within a defined budget and aren't as concerned about a sexy, trendy detail like a blind welted waist, 12 stitches per inch on the outsole, or having really aggressive chiseled lasts. Each of these shoemakers offers a high value for different parts of the market. They each bring their own strengths and opportunities within that designated segment. It's up to you to weigh them against what it is that you're looking for, as well as the trade-offs, and determine if any of those things are deal breakers. If cost is not an issue, I would hands down recommend just going for the Acme Mainline Collection. It's really one of, if not the strongest, price to value ratio in the handmade shoe world. I hope that this was helpful. I know it was a lot of information, but I really enjoyed the process of making all these videos, experiencing and interacting with all of these shoemakers. For those of you that have made it this far into the video, please leave a comment and let me know what your favorite part of the series or favorite part of this video was, and that's how I'll know that you made it this far and I can prioritize getting back to your comments over anybody else's. Let me know if there are any other shoemakers you would like to see featured here on the channel or any other comparisons that you would really enjoy seeing. Again, thanks for sticking around, and I will see you soon.